Lucy, here to talk to you about feminists. You see, in the 1800s, we saw feminists who fought for political equality and the right to vote. But now, in the 1920s, we have the flappers, who fight for the right to sit in the bar and drink and smoke with the men. You know, the flappers were the new feminists. You know, they were not concerned about political equality anymore, but social equality. As my friend, historian Michael Lerner, once stated, women had the right to enjoy themselves socially as much as men did, either through drinking or in indulging in the pleasures of the urban nightlife. I couldn't have said it better myself. These flappers redefined the social pattern by allowing men to accept themselves in the bar and out at the streets. Now we'll cut to one of our friends, a flapper herself.
Thank you, Kyla. I'm here with flapper Elizabeth Swan.
It's Eliza.
So Eliza, what's it like being a flapper?
Being a flapper is just very liberating. You know, I'd like to say that no man can tell me what to do anymore. Now that we have things like birth control, women's suffrage.
What do you do on an average night?
An average night, I'd go drinking, you know, informing the world of my political beliefs and social equality at speakeasies.
Thank you for being with us tonight.
No problem.
Gods are dead, all wars fought, and all faiths shaken, according to Scott Fitzgerald. But Edna St. Vincent Millay hits the nail on the head. My candle burns at both ends. It will not last the night. But ah, my foes, and oh, my friends, it gives a lovely light. So let's jazz it up. Let's neck. Let's pet. Maybe we'll even get blotto. Ain't we got fun?
Show you a short clip of what a flapper's life is like in a speakeasy. Hey girl, on a scale of 1 to America, how free are you tonight?
Get your hands off me, you misogynistic pig. I'm an independent flapper and I don't need no Republican motherhood.
You're a woman who's not gonna amount to anything, so why don't you just come home with me, be my wife, have my kids, and make my sandwiches.
Excuse me? I don't have to listen to you. It's the 1920s. Thanks to birth control and women's suffrage, I don't have to listen to any men anymore, and I can control my own body and my own actions.
Fine, I'll find someone else.
I ain't got time for you, baby. Either you're mine or you're not. Make up your mind, sweet baby. Right here, right now is all we've got. A little party never killed nobody. So we gon' dance until we drop, drop, drop. A little party never killed nobody.
Freely, drinking and smoking as they pleased, and most shockingly, showing off bare knees in revealing dresses, flappers represented the 20th century woman, replacing the outdated and sexist 19th century ideals of women. Flappers redesigned the female role in society. Women like Sanger advocated for birth control so women could take control of their own bodies. Marriages became based on romantic interest rather than arranged marriages, where both partners were seen as equals. Dating replaced courting, and both men and women were free to drink and smoke in speakeasies. Here, women would spread their beliefs on social equality. Flappers could be identified by their short haircuts and risque styles. However, many women were against the flapper image because they thought it was too radical and damaged women's reputations. Suffragettes felt offended because not all flappers invested themselves in politics, but rather petty things like gambling and drinking.
Time for young women within society. Not only did the 19th Amendment get passed in 1919, but utilities such as birth control became available, leveling the social field for men and women. Women, called flappers, followed the radical ways of many female celebrities, such as Clara Bow. These short haircuts and flashy dresses weren't appreciated by all, however. Many suffragists were pushing for the Equal Rights Act and saw the flappers to be frivolous young girls who wanted to rebel against their parents. These caused a divide in the community, leading many people to ask the question of whether flappers were truly feminists. Today, we can now proudly state that they were feminists due to the ability for women to drink, smoke, and express themselves however they choose to do so.